When this group started its journey, the odds of becoming a superstar were 100,000 to 1. Now, 11 remain, and the stakes are higher than ever. On this stage, anything is possible because this is American Idol.
Gentlemen, please welcome your judges, Randy Jackson, Cara DioGuardi, Paula Abdul, and Simon Cowell, and your host, Ryan Seacrest.
Welcome, everybody. Good evening. Nice to have you with us. It is Tuesday night. Time to get your Idol fix. First off, want to wish everybody a happy St. Patrick's Day. After a few pints, this show might really get good tonight. Hopefully it brings us a little good fortune. Tough week, though, last week for Jasmine Murray and Jorge Nunez, as we said goodbye to them. Even though we introduced the judges save, they still ran out of luck. Tonight, we're moving forward, and we're bringing you 2 hours of live performances from our stage here in Hollywood. Randy, has this group really evolved since the small stage?
Dude, let me tell you something. They've all come up, man, pretty big right now. But this week, Ryan, this is always the tough week, man. The second week in Country Week could definitely spoil a little flavor for some of them.
Kara, were you happy with last week in general?
I was. You know, there were some contestants that were better than others, like every week. And I'm hoping the ones that weren't as great do better this week.
And Paula made some big predictions last week about the finale. Do you still stand by those?
I'm standing by him.
Simon, you and country music have a special relationship. Wouldn't you say?
Yeah, you know, I don't think 2 hours is enough, actually, for me. I kind of feel like it should be a week.
Stand by for the lasso. There's a lot on the line for this group tonight. If they make it past the elimination, there's a place for them on the Idol Summer Tour. So make sure you vote to guarantee your favorite will actually be there. Shall we bring them out? Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, your top 11. So tonight we celebrate the Grand Ole Opry. Take a look at this, friends. Country music has always been the heart of America. And at the heart of country music is the Grand Ole Opry. Known as the show that made country music famous, it's the world's longest running live radio show. Beginning in 1925, the greatest legends in country music have graced its stage. But what began as a simple radio broadcast has become the ultimate country music showcase.
it's safe to say.
Perhaps the greatest honor in country music is becoming a member.
This is the pinnacle of what I do. Nothing has ever matched being a member of the Grand Ole Opry.
I feel so honored to be part of the Grand Ole Opry. I've always wanted to be since I was a little girl.
It's joining the ranks of the country music elite and earning an indelible place in history. Recently, one of our own idols, Carrie Underwood, was invited to become a member by legendary country star Randy Travis.
I was asked by the management here at the Grand Ole Opry to come out and ask you if you would like to be their next member.
This past weekend, Randy took time away from his tour to invite the next generation of idols to experience the Opry.
Hello.
I'm digging up home.
In 1986, Randy Travis made a huge impact in country music with the release of his first album, Storms of Life. His quick rise to fame saw him inducted the very same year. This country music icon has recorded 22 number one hits and has sold over 25 million records, making him one of the best-selling solo artists of all time.
I don't know how much I'm going to be able to tell any of you. All of you are down to a fine group of singers here, but if anybody has any questions that I might answer, well, about training horses, I can tell you that. Y'all have quite the group this year together. Probably as strong a group as I've seen in the years that I've been watching American Idol. But I really think it's going to be an enjoyable show. I do.
Good to have you with us, Randy. Good to see you, buddy. Let's get it going with someone who's no stranger to the country genre, Texas native Michael.
Ain't Going Down When the Sun Comes Up has a lot of lyrics. It's loaded with lyrics, and I can say that I feel like I'm taking somewhat of a risk. 6 o'clock on Friday evening, mama doesn't know she's leaving till she hears a screener slamming rubber screeching gears a jamming.
Let's face it, if you blow a few words, your chances of jumping right back in are not high. Really not high. You made some changes within the melody in several places, which is good. I mean, I think Garth will like that.
You know, I didn't try to fit too much into it, but there's a couple of little pieces that I like to add some Michael Sarver flavor to.
Only thing that I would say, because you can sing a lot of great licks, just don't lose the word in a lick, right. You know? So just be careful about
absolutely.
That. That's the only thing.
Thank you so much.
Good job, man. I think it's going to work well for you. I think you'll do a good job.
He's got a lot of words to memorize. Did he do it? Here's Michael Sarver, America.
Yeah, 6 o'clock on Friday evening. Mama doesn't know she's leaving till she hears a screener slamming rubber screeching gears a jamming. Local country station just a blaring on the radio. Pick her up at 7, then they're heading to the rodeo. Mama's on the front porch screaming out her own. Girl, you better get your ready. Packing it before the morning. Yeah, no, ain't going down till the sun comes up. Ain't giving in till they're getting up. Come on, go around the world and I'll pick up the truck. Ain't going down till the sun comes up. I'm dancing midnight south, the hard romance at 1 o'clock. That truck is rocking, two is coming, still no stop. Back to check the clock at 3, they're out on where they wanna be. 4 o'clock, that rooster's coming, 5 o'clock, that rooster's crow. Ain't going down till the sun comes up. Ain't getting in here till they get it out. Going around the world and I'll pick up the road. Ain't going down until the sun comes up. Yeah, 6 o'clock on Saturday, the folks will know he's on his way. The stars are clean, the horses baby say she's got the tissues dead. Here he comes around, I've been slowing out, you're jumping in. Hey, mom, your time is coming, and you're going to the road. Ain't going down till the sun comes up. Ain't getting in here till they get enough. Going around the world and I pick up the road. Ain't going down till the sun comes up.
Mr. Sarver. Yo, baby. So, Mikey, check it out, baby. Check it out. So, you know what? I mean, it was a cool song choice because, I mean, it showed a fun side to you. I'm just not sure, like, it brought, like, some different things out in your vocal capabilities. I'm not sure it showed us that. You know, it was fun, and, I mean, I love the song, but... I don't know.
You know, we got to see a lot of your personality. I like that spot down there with the player, but, you know... It's the big notes that I missed from you for this week. You know, we didn't get to see that this week. And, you know, it's impressive, though, that you could remember all those words.
That's a lot of words.
I don't know. I couldn't. There were a million. How did you do that?
Well, you know, notes are important to me, and singing well is very important to me. But I got to tell you, country music is about having some fun.
I'm not ashamed
of having a blast, because I had a good time.
Yeah. One thing you can tell is that the sun came up a few times with you.
It's a great Garth Brooks song, and I got to tell you that it, to me, allowed to see you having fun, which made us have fun, and your artistic ability to take a harmonica player, it added charm, it boosted your confidence and your fun. I thought that this is the genre that suits you so well and really makes you feel.
Yeah, I mean, it should have been good because I always thought, you know, this kind of music would suit you. Actually, I couldn't understand a single word you were singing, by the way.
Country folks did.
You know, you could have been singing... Not a single word. It was like you could have been singing in Norwegian.
Simon was in my ear doing this.
I wasn't. I thought it was a bit clumsy. And look. Point is, let's just remember what this is about at this point. It is about you coming over as a star. You came over as a likable guy who liked country music, who's a bit clumsy, and this could have been karaoke night in a country and western club
across
America.
If we were all perfect, we wouldn't need this show.
So, Simon, did you like it or not?
On a scale of 1 to 10, I'd give it 1.2.
No!
It wasn't zero.
Or some upside then, right? 1-866-IDOL-01. 1-866-436-5701. If you're with AT&T, you can text the word VOTE to 5701 from your wireless phone. You'll have at least 2 hours to vote, but not until the end of the show. Michael, thank you. Good luck. Good to see you, buddy. That's it for the moment. When we come back, more classic country from Allison and Chris live. With you on Idol Live. As a reminder, all the songs you hear tonight are available on iTunes. To download your favorite, go to the American Idol page on iTunes. Now let's see what Randy Travis had to say about our Allison. Look at this.
Hey,
Allison. Hi. Nice to meet you. When I told him I was gonna sing Blame It On Your Heart by Patti Loveless, his reaction was that Patti was definitely gonna love me singing that.
I knew Allison was gonna do a good job on just about anything she chose to sing.
You got a thing or two to learn about me, baby.
I've been around the business a long time, but I'm not sure I've ever heard quite the maturity in a voice at 16 year old that I hear in Allison.
I like having fun with whatever I do. While I was doing my song, I just jumped in a little dance.
That little move that Allison did.
I was just, you know, having a little fun because it's a fun song.
Don't try to be too cute. Just sing it with the pipes that you have because you got great pipes. That'd be the only advice I'd say to her.
I was just having fun, but I may or may not do it. We'll just see.
Will we see those moves tonight? It's Blame It On Your Heart. Here's Allison Irohita.
Come on, you guys. You got a thing or two to learn about me, baby. Cause I ain't taking this no more, and I don't mean maybe. You don't know right from wrong. Well, the love we had is gone. So blame it on your lying, cheating,
you could sing the alphabet and sing it well. Yeah. I mean, you just bring your own spin to everything, and you really made that song your own, and that's not easy to do. And for me, every week you're just getting better and better, and you just keep going. I thought that was a really solid. Another rock solid performance from Allison, and I gotta tell you something, no one will ever be able to take away the power of your voice and the rock edge that you bring to this competition. I know that after this competition you're gonna be heading into the business, and I think you'll go really far if you also start experimenting with all sides of your vocals and maybe in the way you choose some songs that allow you to be vulnerable and build, because I think you're an amazing artist.
What did you mean by that?
She knows what I meant.
I thought she did, actually. I thought it was good. I thought it was a little bit tuneless in parts. And it was like you were struggling with remembering the words. That's what it looked like to me. Were you? No?
Not really. I mean, I've actually known the song since I was eight years old, but if it sounded like
It was good. I mean, again, like the girl said, it was, you know, you're rock solid. Verging on precocious in a little bit.
But we like that.
Well, guess what? Guess what? No. Guess what? Guess what?
Guess what? Precocious is good.
It is good.
Yeah. I didn't think it was precocious at all. I thought it was dope.
Something for everybody watching. Dopely precocious, Allison. So you weren't thinking about the words of that song at all?
Not really. No.
Probably the 30 million people watching.
Probably the 30 million. That happens.
If you want to vote for Allison, 1-866-IDOLS-02. That's 1-866-436-5702. If you thought she was dope, you can text her and vote to 5702. These are 866 numbers, not 800 numbers. So dial carefully. Thank you very much, Allison. Good luck. Let's keep it going. Advice now from Randy Travis for Chris. Take a look at this one.
The song I chose to sing is To Make You Feel My Love by Garth Brooks. It's kind of one of those songs that's really captivating. And so when you just strip it down like that, it gets really easy to get into.
But I will never do.
Chris is very much a strong ballad singer. That is his strong suit. It's one of those things, if the audience really listens to the words and listens to his vocal performance on it, he'll do really well with it. Good job.
Thank you, sir.
You made it yours. You didn't just copy Garth's record. Garth would be proud of that. He'll like that.
Randy had said that I didn't copy Garth's version, which is nice to hear, because I don't want to go up there and just sing someone else's song. I want to go up there and make a song my own.
Well, I appreciate it, sir.
He made it his. He did a good job with it. I was very impressed with that.
Let us see how it pays off on stage, singing without his guitar tonight. Here's Chris Allen.
When the rain is blowing in your face and the whole world is on your case, I could offer you a warm embrace to make you feel my love. I know you haven't made your mind up yet, but I will never do you wrong. I've known it from the moment that we met. There's no doubt in my mind where you belong. I could make you happy, make your dreams come true, go to the ends of the earth for you. There ain't nothing that I wouldn't do to make you feel my love. To make you feel my love.
All right, Chris. Well, I'm surprised, and I'm pleasantly surprised. I think it was a real honest, pure, and vulnerable performance, and without having your guitar, it allowed me to remember how nice your vocals are. There were some that were the notes that you throw away that are low, you gotta make sure they're on pitch, and you know, with a few pitchy moments at the end, but overall, I think that this was a really smart choice for you to do this, and to see you without the guitar and just focus on you.
Thank you. Thank you, Paula.
Chris, I thought that was terrific. Really, really good. I did. It was a great, great, great choice of song. I thought the way that you kind of took it all back, you were completely in control of the song. You just concentrated on you. You didn't go over the top. Very smart choice of song. That, in a way, probably is the first time I've actually heard you perform where I genuinely am beginning to think you've actually got a shot of doing really well in this competition.
You know, like Simon and Paula just said, you know what's really cool for me, man, is that you went out on a limb and you took that chance just to showcase your vocals. And I was like, wow. Tender moments for my dog, Chris. Who knew? Who knew, baby? Who knew you had those tender moments? You know what I mean? You
He's
coming out dancing,
dog.
Doing all the... Yeah, I love that.
Tender and vulnerable.
He's a tender.
A tender dog. A tender dog.
Pure.
Hey.
Tender dog. There we go.
Pure, tender dog.
And I didn't even know that it was Opryland when I was hearing that song. It wasn't even country. It just was beautiful.
Chris
and
Allen.
It was very Chris Allen.
Very good.
It was. Very good.
It's like the wind was taken out of you when you heard that feedback. So, how does that feel?
It feels amazing. Just good comments are always good. So.
I'm always nervous, too, listening, especially to Simon sometimes when he starts with the compliment, followed by the compliment. You're waiting for the but.
Yeah.
But it never came, so congratulations.
Thank you.
If you like the tender dog... Tender dog?
And boyish.
Yeah,
boyish.
And vulnerable.
In fact,
yes.
He's a puppy. He's a tender puppy.
1-866-IDOLS-03. 1-866-436-5703. Or you can text the word vote to 5703. Chris, thank you very much. Can we come back? Keep the country with Lil Rounds live. Hang on. Welcome back to the show. Want to see more of The Idols? You can go to AmericanIdol.com to see behind-the-scenes videos presented by Coca-Cola. Here with Lil Rounds now. How much time do you and the contestants spend together between shows?
We spend quite a few time together. I mean, we are always laughing and talking because we get to share a kitchen together, and we have a pool that we get in, hot tub, different things like that. So. We spend quite a bit of time.
And what did you think when you heard we were going to do country this week?
The first thing I thought was the only country songs that I have really heard have been on movies. And and I was like, okay, so now I have to really learn a song and pull it off. And I'm kind of nervous about it because I don't want to put too much of my R&B feel into it because I really want to honor the country.
So you're going to hold back a little bit?
I'm going to hold back a little bit, and I'm going to really honor country week.
This is an experiment now.
Yeah.
Lil Rounds and Randy Travis, take a look.
Now, I understand you are doing Martina McBride, Independence Day.
Yes.
That's a big song. That's a big undertaking.
Yeah, she seemed all right by dawn's early light. The original version, you know, is slower than what I sung for him.
The only thing I would say, and it's mainly in the verses that I would say this about, if you could slow it down just a little bit.
He said it would be easier for me to actually get my licks and my riffs in.
We can try it, yeah.
Well, she seemed all right by
because it's such a well-written song. You want to understand all the lyrics. And when she slowed that down to me, it felt like she relaxed a little more.
I like that. Slow down a little bit.
Great. Well, just give a little more space in there for the licks that you do. She goes out and does the vocal that I just heard. She nailed that. man, she's got pipes on the top end. I mean, big pipes on the top end.
Let's see how it turned out. Here is Independence Day, Little Rounds.
Well, she seemed all right by dawn's early light, though she looked a little worried and weak. She tried to pretend he wasn't drinking again, but Daddy left the proof on her cheek. And I was only 8 years old that summer, and I always seemed to be in the way. So I took myself down to the fair in town on Independence Day. Now some folks whisper and some folks talk, but everybody looked the other way. And when time ran out, there was no one about on Independence Day.
Interesting, ambitious song choice. And in the front part of it, I found myself like struggling a little bit. When you hit your power zone, by the time you hit the chorus and you opened up, because you're a big power singer, you got that big old range, it got a little bit better, but I don't know. It didn't feel comfortable for me on you. I'm just keeping it real. I'm just keeping it real. It was just kind of all right.
But
it just wasn't great.
I wanted to try something different. I really did. I wanted to do something different. I wanted to, you know, show everybody that R&B is not the only thing I can sing, you know. I just really want to give it a go.
No, I know, but, you know, we were even saying, you know, you could have chosen I Will Always Love You, written by the great Dolly Parton, which, you know, I'm saying.
Or How Do I Live?
I
thought about that, but I felt this song was really relevant, well, even for now.
And that's part of being an artist, is to make it feel.
I mean, it's a great song.
Here's the thing. We all know you're a great singer. I mean, you'd have to be deaf to not know that, right? So it is the second half, we start to get the Lil that we all fall in love with. The girl's hitting those notes that are in the sky. Right. And we kind of missed that at the beginning. And there were other songs you could have chosen. But you know what? You did what you felt. And that's part about being an artist, is standing your ground. So I give you props for that. Is it the best performance? Not your best. But good for standing your ground.
Thank you. Lil, I think everything's going right for you tonight. I think your vocals are spot on. I think that the hair, the makeup, the clothing is beautiful. And the only thing, in reference to what these two are saying, it would have worked better if you didn't sing two verses and you only sang one verse and went straight to the chorus so that your vocals could go piercing through. Yeah.
It's not,
you know that, because when your voice pierces through, that's why you are the obvious one of the obvious favorites.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
So it was just the one verse. So obvious. Look, Little. It was
Little.
Little. What? It's the same thing.
Lil.
That song
Lil.
Will Little. We'll make Lil. Okay, Lil. But the little. Okay, little.
Lil.
Yeah. Which is short for little. For me, it kind of came over as if you were one of those girls who have to sing at a wedding and are forced to sing a song somebody's requested and felt and looked. And looked uncomfortable because we were comparing you when we first met you to someone like Mary J, who had a kind of a rawness.
It's country.
There are a million billion songs.
I'm really trying to let everybody know, really. I'm trying to really show America that this is a learning process for all of us.
May I talk little?
Oh, Simon, it's Lil.
Okay. Lil. You could have done something like when an R&B singer takes something like a John Montgomery song and turn it into something that will suit you. I thought that just wasn't you.
What about Stand By Your Man?
No.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. Some colorful feedback there from the judges. What do you get out of all that?
What I got out of it was, you know, I was trying to do something new, which I, you know, did on tonight. But I understand exactly what they were saying. When I do pick my songs from now on, you know, America Keeps Me Around, I promise you, you will always get Lil Rain.
These contestants are good, aren't they? Good. Well said. Simon, you should know that Randy calls you the Lil Judge behind closed doors. 1-866-IDOLS-04, 1-866-436-5704, or you can text the word VOTE to 5704. Please don't vote until the end of the show. Thanks, Lil. That's it for now. When we come back, Adam Lambert takes the stage. Welcome back to American Idol. Adam Lambert, ladies and gentlemen. So we just saw Lil Rounds to engage a little self-discipline in terms of her power. Is this country song going to be signature, Adam?
Of course, yeah. I don't know about self-discipline, but it'll be signature.
By the way, you're about to see some priceless video of Randy Travis and Adam. Two antithetical personalities and people, I would say. What was it like with Randy for you?
He was such a gentleman, you know. He gave me great advice, great criticism. Just, you know, told me to focus on the words, and that's one of the reasons why I picked the song. The lyrics are awesome.
And check out his reaction to the nail polish. Ladies and gentlemen, watch this.
My initial reaction to Grand Ole Opry Week was kind of like, oh. So I'm doing the Ring of Fire.
Did you learn this from Cash's version?
I found a different version of it. It has like this Middle Eastern kind of flair on it. There's sitar, like Middle Eastern percussion.
I'm speechless.
Love is a burning thing.
I don't even know what to say about this boy.
It's a fiery ring.
That particular arrangement of a Johnny Cash song threw me for a loop. I give you points for unique.
That's what I'm going for.
I don't see myself as a country artist, and obviously he doesn't either.
I'm guessing you're probably not going to become a member of the Grand Ole Opry next week or
maybe
anything
not,
like that.
Maybe not, yeah.
For me, I don't see men wearing nail polish that often, so it sort of caught me off guard, but Adam seemed like a very nice guy and, again, a great singer.
So here he is rocking the black nail polish and the turquoise highlights, Adam Lambert.
And it makes a fiery ring, bound by a wild desire. I fell into a ring of fire. I fell into a burning ring of fire. Went down, 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 and the flames got higher. And it burns, burns, burns. The ring of fire, the ring of fire. The taste of love is sweet as hearts like ours meet. I fell for you like a child. Oh, but the fire
does country music. That's very interesting. I've never quite seen that sort of a country type of rendition. But, you know, the fire, the Egyptian thing, all a little strange. I don't know what to make of that. You know, I got my drama that I love from you. I got those eyes. They were very fabulous. But, you know, it was strange, but I kind of liked it. Strange, but I liked it. It left me confused and sort of happy. I don't know.
Wow. Dazed and confused.
All right, so this is what I think, and I find this truly amazing about you. You know, you are really someone who stands out, who is true to who you are as an artist. Although it's Country Music Week, the choice of song was a great song. I love the Middle Eastern sitar sounds, and it sounded a little bit like Kashmir Led Zeppelin feeling to me, and I think that's what makes you, you're either a quick study or a born natural. I kind of think that you're both, and you're raising your own bar each week, and we're going to keep expecting more and more great things out of you.
Thank you.
I think what Randy was trying to say was, what the hell was that? I mean, sorry, but I would never go to Nashville if I were you, Adam, because
no plan.
I think there are a lot of people throwing their television sets out the window at this point because...
No!
I thought it was... absolute indulgent rubbish, if you want my honest opinion. I mean, really, really horrific.
No. I think, listen,
a little weird.
I think what was really great, the greatest thing about it, if you can imagine Nine Inch Nails doing a country song, that's what it was. It's current, it's young, it's fresh, it's hot.
Ladies and gentlemen. So no plans to go to Nashville, you were saying?
Not at all.
Yeah.
No.
I was just thinking, we've come a long way since Taylor Hicks stood right here, huh?
Yeah, Randy, I'll give you that.
Randy, what'd you think? Still speechless. To vote for Adam, 1-866-805. 1-866-436-5705. Or you can text the word vote to 5705. Thanks. After the break, Martina McBride from Scott McIntyre. Hang on. Welcome back to American Idol in the mosh pit. We're drawing inspiration from Nashville tonight, the Grand Ole Opry. Okay, hold on one
second. What are you going to sing and play for us today?
Wild Angels by Martina McBride.
Okay. to be honest right, with you, I didn't tell him this, but I'm thinking, not good. This may not be the choice for you.
Between the perfect world and the bottom line, keeping love alive.
The first time through that I played my song for Randy, he noticed that the tempo was a little bit slow.
Did you pick up the tempo just slightly in the verse?
Okay.
Vocally, he sounded fine. But to me, I'm trying to figure out what does not sound quite right to me.
Wild angels.
A little bit more like that.
That's pretty impressive.
Well, thank
you. I wish I could play piano like that. I think Scott surprised me more than anyone so far. I think he'll go out and do fine.
Jonas Brothers concert down here. Here he is again on the Baby Grand, Scott McIntyre.
Perfect world and the bottom line, keeping love alive in these troubled times. Well, it's a miracle in itself, and we know too well what that's about. Still, we made it through, only God knows how. We must have had a little help. must have been wild angels, wild angels, watching over you and me. Yeah, yeah. Some nights I watch you while you dream. I swear I hear the sound.
Tonight was another impressive, lovely performance, and you know, you work harder than most people on that stage. I really do feel, though, that that the piano may be a bit of a crutch now, and that it separates you from the audience, and I think that people need to see you as a showman as well.
We can move it closer.
I don't want your performances to be similar to any week, and I just want you to mix it up a little bit so that there's a great connection.
Well, Paula, what do you expect him to do?
Maybe sometimes not be with the piano.
Okay, I think it's a bit of a stupid thing to say that.
Well,
it's like,
you can think
it is
that
really.
It's stupid.
Well, it is, because.
Stop being disrespectful, Simon.
Well, I think you're being disrespectful. He's very comfortable behind the piano. There's nothing
Simon,
wrong with that.
I
Elton John always used to sit behind the piano.
Yeah.
Nothing wrong with that. That's what you want to do.
Still does. Still does. Still does.
And so does Billy Joel.
So,
and so,
okay,
so does Stevie
Elton,
Wonder.
Billy,
and so
you know,
does
take Paula's
Ray
advice.
Charles,
don't play
so
the
does,
piano. You
no,
know?
He's a brilliant pianist and he's a brilliant vocalist. I just want him to mix it up so that the connection is still there with the audience. That's
I don't
all
think it's
I'm
got
saying.
Anything to do with the piano
well,
whatsoever.
Well, then that's your opinion. I respect that. Song.
No, you don't.
Oh.
Yes,
I'll tell
I
you
do.
What I think. I think for me, both performances last week and this week were very, very similar in terms of the song you chose. I don't think yet you're choosing good enough songs to make you feel that emotional.
I've also lost a lot of hat picks, by
what?
The way, for songs
song
last few
picks.
Weeks. But I like the song because it just, you know, no one's going to expect me to come out and sing a Martina McBride song anyways, so it, you know, at least that was surprising, hopefully.
No, but as I said, you know, I like you a lot, but I think you're choosing songs which just do a little bit of that. They're just going over my head, and I forget them afterwards.
That's disrespectful.
Yeah, and I...
That's not disrespectful.
Know, yeah,
that's actually
okay,
good
right
advice.
Along. Moving right along.
You.
No, you're not.
Yes.
Moving right along.
Hi,
Andy. Hi, Carol.
Hi, Randy. How are you?
Going
nice to see you.
So, listen, for me, I think it's not so much the songs that you're choosing. I'm looking for those hot, crazy, unbelievable vocals from you. In the last 2 weeks, this weekend, last week, I haven't seen it. It's all just been a nice, kind of good performance. I'm just looking for
safe.
The standout vocals, because this is a singing competition.
Thank you.
Okay, and I'm gonna sum up the fight and Randy. What everyone's saying is, I think we want you to up your game a little bit. You know, really deliver it. Go for those high notes. Show us, wow us.
No, just choose
a little
better
bit
songs.
More. That's what we're saying.
Just
that's
sing
what
best.
We're all
choose
saying.
Better songs.
But you know what the good note is? You bring class and poise to that
yes,
stage.
Yes, you do. Amen.
Scott McIntyre. Paula makes the point that you work hard up on the stage and with the band. You work a lot with the arrangement, yeah?
I do. You know, most of the downtime we have back at the mansion or whatever, whenever we're there, I'm either sleeping or I'm arranging the song. I really like to create that experience with the audience just to shape the song and have the beginning, middle, and end, the highs and lows, you know, so.
And Scott, going back to the piano for a second, listening to what Simon and Paula had to say,
Who are you going to listen to? Which one of them?
You know, I was going to tell Paula, if America honors me with the privilege of being in the top 10, I will definitely come out at some point without the piano. I'm not going to tell you when, but
I've been thinking about that.
Surprise.
But I really appreciate your feedback, but I hope I did enough to at least get through next
week. So what happens if it's Elton John?
Say it again, Simon.
Well, I was just saying, I mean, don't feel under any pressure, because it could be Elton John week, it could be Billy Joel week.
It could be Bruce Hornsby week, Ray Charles week.
Oh, right, okay, that makes sense.
I won't be dropping the piano anytime soon.
Good, okay.
Well, he gave us a nice super tease, so stay tuned if he makes it through to see what he does next for Scott.
Week by week.
1-866-IDOLS-06. 1-866-436-5706. If you're with AT&T, you can text the word vote to 5706 from your wireless phone. Don't vote until the end of the show. Scott, thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
A very compelling conversation. We're going to take a break. By the way, people have told her she looks like Dolly Parton. After the break, see what happens when she takes on one of her songs. Grand Ole Opry Week continues with Alexis Grace. Hang on. Welcome back to American Idol. I'm here with Alexis Grace, ladies and gentlemen. So, it's kind of tense out here. What have you been thinking watching the show backstage tonight?
Well, we've been backstage, and we think everybody sounds great back there, you know. And we're just trying to have a good time and laugh and sing, just doing stupid stuff.
Were you a little worried about coming out after the Paula and Simon fight?
You know, actually, I didn't see the Paula and Simon fight. I was backstage, so I didn't get to hear it.
Well, they both just stormed off the set, separate doors. But you'll be fine with country. You're comfortable with the genre.
I love country music. You know, I'm from the South, and, you know, we all like country down there, so.
Alexis, Grace, and Travis, take a look. Good luck.
It's an honor. You're an amazing writer. I like to write music. That's why I chose the song I did. Jolene.
That's a good one to choose. That's a good one to choose for you.
It was a really easy transition for me to pick the song. It's very soft, and I wanted to show that side of me to America because I don't think they've seen it yet. Jolene.
To me, Alexis did a great job with Dolly's song. Happiness depends. She seems like someone who understands what telling the story is about. Great job. My gosh, yeah. That's perfect. I don't know anything that I would say change.
After I sang, I was just kind of in shock. Yeah. That was fun. I just got to sing for Randy Travis. Should have added like a yee-haw at the end of that or something. It was nice meeting you.
I think Dolly will be proud when she gets to hear the show and hear what she did with the song, yeah. No doubt.
It is a Dolly Parton classic, Jolene from Lexus.
Your beauty is beyond compare, with flaming locks of auburn hair, ivory skin and eyes of emerald green. Jolene, 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 I'm begging of you, please don't take my man. Jolene, 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 please don't take him just because you. Could have your choice of man, but I will never love again. He's the only one for me. Jolene, Jolene, I had to have this talk with you. My happiness depends on you and whatever you decide to do.
Yo, It's a great song. I'm just not sure you just hit the notes quite well. There was a bunch of pitch problems, and also you tried to bend it a little too much in a bluesy sort of way that sometimes didn't quite work. I just think it was a good song choice for you. I enjoyed that, but it just wasn't a great performance of me.
Okay. I was just trying to bring my own little flavor to it.
No,
you know?
I get that. It just didn't, there was a little pitch problems everywhere.
I think you lost your edge a bit. And that's what was a little bit disappointing for me. I could have seen like Last Name or Before He Cheats, that kind of edgy that brings out that angst in you that we all fell in love with in the beginning. It was just a little flat for me. You know? Mm-hmm.
Okay.
You know, here's what I think. I think that song was more effective than maybe the others think for you. And I'll the reason why I think that is because we're used to going all out with the down and dirty vocals and powering through. Sometimes you took an artistic approach by showing different sides of your vocals. And I think that by doing that, you're able to tell a story from beginning to end. I don't care about pitch problems. I really enjoyed the vulnerable, soft side of you, too.
That's what I wanted to do. I wanted to show my soft side. And
I agree.
Give variety, you know?
Yes. Why not?
Simon?
Look, I thought it was okay. I thought it was a little bit sound-alike, you know, so I didn't really hear much... Sorry?
What does sound-alike mean?
It means that you sound like the person you're trying to sing.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so it was like a little that. So I didn't hear an awful lot of originality. I thought the vocals were okay. I think it is one of those performances tonight we're going to forget about in about 10 minutes' time.
Yeah. Oh, please don't. Please don't forget about it. I had fun.
Good. Alexis Grace. So, now listen to that feedback. Would you have done anything differently with that song?
No, I would have kept it the same except, you know, maybe I would have put a little bit more dirty in there, but, you know.
You missed that.
You missed the dirty?
You still dirty. We missed the dirty.
She still had dirty.
Don't worry, because if I'm back here next week, you know, there'll be some dirty. You dirty it up.
There you have it, America. If you want to stay tuned for that next week, dial 1-866-IDOL-07. 1-866-436-5707. Or you can text the word vote to 5707. Calls are toll free from landlines. Standard text messaging rates apply. Thank you and good luck, Alexis.
Thank you. All right, thanks.
When we come back, we've got some Carrie Underwood coming to you from Danny Gokey. Hang on. Welcome back to Idol. As a reminder, all the songs you hear tonight are available on iTunes. To download your favorite, hit up the American Idol page on iTunes. Now, what went down when Randy met Danny? Let's take a look.
Standing in front of Randy was... I got nervous. I have to be honest. She was... Let's do it again.
Today, Danny walked in with the Carrie Underwood record, Jesus Take the Wheel.
And so I start reading off the paper. Jesus Take the Wheel. I came in late on that last note. And I messed up again. She didn't even have time to cry. And again. Before she knew it, she was... It was... And again. If I could just get the word. She was driving last Friday on her way to Cincinnati.
It's one of those, you better hope that night you are close to 100%. But boy, when Danny was singing the pieces that he knew, man, it's a soulfulness that most of us who make a living as a singer wish that we had.
Travis and Gokey working together. Did he get it right? We're about to find out. Ladies and gentlemen, Danny Gokey.
She was driving last Friday on her way to Cincinnati on a snow-white Christmas Eve. Going home to see her mama and her daddy with the baby in the back seat. 50 miles ago, she was running low on faith and gasoline. It'd been a long, hard year. She had a lot on her mind and she didn't pay attention. She was going way too fast. Before she knew it, she was spinning on a thin black sheet of glass. She saw both the lights flash before her eyes.
She didn't even have time to cry. She was so scared. She threw her hands up in the air. Jesus, take the wheel. Take it from my head. 'Cause I can't do this on my own. I'm letting go. Give me one more chance. Save me from this road I'm on. Jesus, take the wheel. Yeah. Oh, oh, oh. I'm letting go. Give me one more chance. Save me from this road I'm on. Jesus, take the wheel.
Stride, it's like none other. I mean, it's just like, woo, right? The front half of that performance for me was not spectacular, but halfway through, it was like, here comes Danny. Danny came out of his shell and went straight up, and I wish I'd had 10 minutes of that and not the front half.
Sure.
Because really, when you get up there and you hit those powerful notes, it's a connection unlike anything. So when you pick those songs, be careful that you're picking them in that range.
I kind of disagree in the sense that I love when artists build a story, and that they, I know that the, that Danny,
but don't you,
I love it. We all wait for it. But if it was always that notch, then we'd love it, but we'd fall a little short of like appreciating you. I think you were brilliant tonight. I think Carrie Underwood would not only approve, she'd go out and buy that record.
Wow. Yeah. Simon Cowell?
I don't think she'd rush out to buy it, but I do actually agree with Paula that I think that if it, I'll tell you why, because you can't start that song full on. You know, I mean, you've got to have a little bit of light and shade. You can't scream the song from the beginning.
I didn't say for a
right. My right. Only problem, Danny, is actually what you're wearing.
No, Simon, I like the jacket.
It's like you're going on some sort of polar expedition or something, and it's 80 degrees in Los Angeles today.
Don't talk to him about fashion, Danny. Don't talk to him about fashion.
Yeah, really.
But it's not cold, is it?
No, it's not. You know what? Matt Gerard says I'm real funny. He said I look like I was getting ready to jump out of an airplane.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Well, Danny,
it's a bit bulky.
I actually today agree with Kara. The problem with you in the verses, the rest of the song, dude, you blaze. It was crazy, right?
Yeah.
But the verses, you got to support those enough because you're a great singer and you want to get better on this show. And the verses were a little pitchy and a little. Just support them better, man. But you're a great singer. You know what I'm saying?
You are. You're a great
Come
singer.
Come on, man. Get it together. Come on, Danny.
It's warm in here tonight. All right.
It's all right.
So we're split down the middle at the panel. Did you feel yourself let go during that song? Was that intentional?
Yeah, well, I wanted to start it slow. You know, it's a low song right there. And so I didn't know what to do with it. So I know one thing. I need to clean up. And like he said, I agree with you, Randy. I'm still trying to clean it up. And I'm going to keep cleaning it up.
Support it, baby. Support it.
Listen to the audience.
Danny's number is 1-866-0-8, 1-866-436-5708, or you can text the word vote to 5708. Thank you very much, Danny. All right. What a night. Don't go anywhere. On the other side of the break, Anoop is live. Right down the middle.
back to American Idol. They share the same home state of North Carolina. But what advice did Randy Travis have for our Anoop? Let's see.
Anoop.
I was a little apprehensive about Grand Ole Opry week at first. It's not really my forte.
I saw you doing You're Always on My Mind.
Yes.
So I'm anxious to hear your version of it. Seeing You're Always on My Mind, I mean, it's hard to get Willie out of your mind when you've heard that version.
But you're always on my mind.
All the doubt I had went away when he got into the first few lines.
Always on my mind.
After my last performance, Simon said that I didn't deserve to be in the top 13. That was sort of the impetus for me to change my style of singing this week.
Heck, that was good, man. Just hold off on the lick till you get into the song a little bit farther.
Okay.
It adds to the effect of the building process that you have going on. It's, gosh, man, good. People will rethink his capability as a singer. This will be the best anyone has heard from Anoop.
Judges agree, performing Always on My Mind, made famous by Willie Nelson and Opry member Johnny Cash. Here is Anoop Desai.
Maybe I didn't love you quite as often as I could have. Maybe I didn't treat you quite as good as I could have. If I made you feel second best, girl, I'm sorry I was blind. But you're always on my. You're always on my mind. Tell me, darling, tell me that your sweet love hasn't died. Oh, and give me one more chance to keep you satisfied.
For picking a song that allowed you to have your interpretation of it, and it fit you like a glove, as opposed to last week, the glove didn't fit you.
Yes, ma'am.
But this one, it really did. And I'm really proud of you, because your vocals, when you are allowed to have that space in between, you got tender, honest, amazing, sweet vocals, and you touched my heart.
Another tender doll.
Anoop, you've just managed to go from zero to hero. That was a good choice of song. Actually, in a way, that was one of my favorite performances of the whole night. And you know what, Anoop? Good for you that you can take bit of a kicking last week, which was thoroughly deserved. By the way, I take back what I say.
Thank you.
Definitely deserved to be in this show. But you didn't kind of whine about it. You just took the good advice, did something about it, chose a great song, delivered a great vocal. Glad to have you back, Anoop.
Thank you so much.
Yo. Let me just say, Let me just say, man, this is the reason that we really wanted you in this competition, the Snoop Dogg. You can really sing, and you proved it tonight, man. It wasn't a Bobby Brown thing. It wasn't you jumping around just having a good time. You could do that, too, but you really showed your vocal skills. And let me just say something, dude. I like the arrangement. The band, you, whoever came up with it, dude, the arrangement was dope. Nice.
Very hard to do what you did tonight. That is a classic song, untouchable almost. And to do what you did tonight is amazing. And for me, probably the best performance of the night, because the biggest surprise. Yeah. The biggest surprise. I only agree with the song.
Anoop Desai. Are you surprised by that feedback?
I'm going to say no, because I expect myself to do the best every single time.
If you want to vote for Anoop, 1-866-IDOLS-09. 1-866-436-5709, or you can text the word vote to 5709. Anoop, welcome back. When we come back from the break, a country standard from Megan Joy. Hang tight, friends. With you now live in Hollywood. Two more for you tonight. Let's keep it going with Megan Joy.
Hi, Megan.
Hi, it's so nice to meet you. The
pressure's on from this point on. I'll say this, it's fun to watch. It's fun to watch, but I wouldn't want to be in your shoes. What are you singing today?
I'm singing I Go Walking After Midnight.
And to be honest, I'm thinking this has been done every possible way a human could think of. Okay.
Randy just kind of seemed a little hesitant. So I put my twist on it, and it is what it is.
I go a-walking after midnight.
It was totally unique. Good job.
Thank you.
Yeah, totally unexpected notes that you sang in a couple of areas and chord changes that you play, yeah.
I had to change it to be comfortable.
Do it just like that.
Okay.
You go. She goes out and does this song and nails every vocal lick, all the things that she has done different to this particular song. You'd have to like it.
Let's see if Randy's prediction rings true. Here is Megan Joy.
I go a-walking after midnight out in the moonlight. Just like we used to do, I'm always walking after midnight, searching for you. I walk for miles along the highway. Well, that's just my way of saying I love you. I'm always walking after midnight, searching for you.
You glad that one's over, right? Have you been a little ill, CSU coughing? Let me tell you something. Listen, I thought it was going to kind of be a little bit of a train wreck, but I must say, I was quite impressed. I thought it was actually really good. And I also thought it kind of being kind of the rocky, bluesy, country, soul, jazzy kind of Megan thing, it actually all really worked and was a perfect choice for you. Good work.
Thank you.
Perfect song, perfect look. And here's the thing. You're a winner because not a lot of people with the flu would be able to get up in front of 25, 30 million people and do what you did tonight. That shows you are serious. And I like that about you because being an artist is hard work. That's great spirit. Good job tonight, girl.
Thank you. And I'm going to say on top of that, people don't know, she's been in the hospital and back. She didn't get to do the run through. And I got to tell you, Megan, you're a fighter. You are the consummate professional. And, you know, if this is what sick is being about, have at it. Keep being sick, because you were fantastic tonight. I just mean that.
I was going to say that. I mean, you should have flu every week.
Yeah.
Because you were better this week than you were last week.
Absolutely.
And you look gorgeous. The only thing I think is that whoever's styling you at the moment is kind of sucking away some of the quirkiness which we liked about you. It's all a little bit like
I'm going to
the prom tonight.
Yeah, a little made up. It's a little made up.
It's not a tribute. That wasn't a tribute, was it?
She's beautiful.
Yeah, but still hot. Still hot, but a little too made up.
You know what? You can either take fashion advice from him or girl.
I know.
Oh, thank you.
Dr. Nasseri said influenza B, so she's very sick. If you want to vote for Megan, 1-866-IDOLS-10, 1-866-436-5710, or text her and vote to 5710. Don't vote until the end of the show. Thank you. Good luck, Megan. Feel better. When we come back, the final performance of the night, it's Matt Gerard. Go rest. Welcome back to American Idol. Here's what happened when Matt met Randy Travis.
What are you singing?
I'm singing So Small by Carrie Underwood.
Interesting choice.
Yeah.
When he said he was doing Carrie's song here, I felt I'm not sure this is a great choice.
Sometimes those mountains you've been climbing.
And then as I'm standing there listening to him sing this, way different version than Carrie's, of course. You get to see the soulfulness come out in his singing, and he did a great job. Yeah, you surprised me. I'd say you made that yours.
My approach to the song is to bring it down a little bit, make it a more emotional, heartfelt version, and do my own thing with it.
I never thought I'd sing for you.
If he does what I just heard him do, he'll look great, sound great, people will love it.
Let's see if he nails it. Put your hands together for Matt Gerard. Stop.
What you got if you ain't got love? The kindness you just want to give away. It's okay to open up. Go to hell and let your light shine through. I know it's hard on a rainy day. You want to shut the world out and just be left alone, but don't run out on your faith. Sometimes that mountain you've been climbing is just a grain of sand. What you've been out there searching for forever is in your figure out that love is all that matters after all. It sure makes everything else seem so small. Sometimes those mountains you've been climbing are just a grain of sand. It sure makes everything else seem so small.
Matt, there ain't nothing small about you. That's for sure. You're an artist. artist. You're a true talent. Your heart pours on that piano. You work the dynamics of that song. Amazing. I love you.
Thank
you. I just do.
Yeah. Thank you.
What I applaud you most about Matt is the authenticity. You're the authentic performer. The authenticity that you bring and the honesty that you bring with your delivery is really unparalleled tonight. And I got to tell you, you're piercing through so many people's hearts, and you certainly have pierced them. And one more thing, it shows you what a great song, because a few people sang Carrie Underwood. Kudos, Carrie Underwood, for allowing these kids to sing.
Oh, thank you. I'm not going to say no. Yes, Matt, you are a heart piercer. I don't think you've had enough credit, actually, for your vocals in this competition so far, because everyone's been talking about Danny and Adam. I think you're quite similar to Danny.
Yes.
Tonight, I think you outsang him. I genuinely do. It was a great performance. You remind me of Michael Bublé. You know, you're very comfortable. So I thought that was a terrific performance, one of the best tonight. Well done.
Dude, Noah, for me, it was my favorite performance of the night, man, because, Woo! Listen, I've been saying every week, I love your vocals, you got mad skills, and you know what's interesting? You hear Michael Bublé, you hear me say Justin Timberlake, look at the miles between those two. You got it going on, baby.
Congratulations, man. I feel comfortable and good, dude.
That feels great, man. I love that song, and I feel like I can really put my own emotion on it, so.
We have got ourselves a competition, friends. It is on. 1-866-IDOLS-11. 1-866-436-5711. Or you can text the word vote to 5711. Thank you, Matt Bublé. We're going to open the lines up in just a second. Remember to vote for your favorites. At this point, no one is safe. Here are the phone numbers one more time.
Just my way of saying I love you.
seems so small.
There it is, America. The lines are now open. They'll stay open for at least 2 hours. Thank you to our judges. Ricky Minor and the band. Coming in tomorrow night, we've got performances from Brad Paisley and a duet from Randy Travis and Carrie Underwood. That's all happening 9, 8 Central tomorrow night. Good luck to all of you. Vote. Local news is next. Good night, everybody.